So I've come home and I'm faced with the following situation. The TV's plugged in, but it won't work. The games console's plugged in, yes, and it won't work. As well as the iPad, it's in and charging, but the device won't boot up, Joe. What could have caused this?
Well, it's very possible that your house has been subjected to what we call a surge event, and that has damaged your delicate electronic piece of equipment that you've listed there. Now, this is a problem that has been around for quite some time, and it's a problem that's not going to go away anytime soon. So in this video, we're going to look at what surge is. We're going to look at how you can protect yourself from it so that when your electrician tells you that you need to have surge protection devices installed into your property, you have a good idea of what they're talking about.
If these surge events aren't a new problem, Joe, why is it becoming more of a problem nowadays?
Well, it's because of the rise in use of electronic components in everyday items. So if you take a little look around this house, guys, what sort of loads might you find that could be affected by surge events?
Yeah, we've got things such as smoke detectors, we've got a live audio speaker in the bathroom, and as we work our way down into here, we've got things like LED lighting, mm-hmm. and we've got a boiler control I can see here, which has no screen working on it.
Absolutely, and you might even be thinking about things like washing machines, yeah. dishwashers, tumble dryers, and even USB charging sockets. All of these things are at risk from surge events. So while surge events aren't new, they've been part of our electrical system for a long, long time, we're seeing a greater impact of them because of the types of load that we're connecting up in our properties.
And do they need to be on and working in order to be affected by a surge?
No, if they're plugged in, yeah. and the socket on the wall is switched on, then even though that piece of equipment might not necessarily be on, it's still connected and therefore could be at risk from a surge event.
So we're seeing the type of items in a domestic dwelling that can be damaged due to surge. But what is surge?
Well, surge is best explained by the technical term for it, which is transient overvoltage. In other words, for a very short period of time, the voltage coming into your property goes too high, causing that damage that we saw earlier.
Okay, we're in a beautiful location. There must be a reason you've dragged me outside, Joe.
Well, we've come out here to have a look at the source of one of these surges. So if you look above us here, you can see you've got these power lines and these are feeding the properties behind us. Now, if there's a thunderstorm and lightning should hit these power lines or even something close to the power lines without actually touching them, that can be enough to cause that temporary overvoltage that we saw earlier.
And that overvoltage can cause damage to the electronic components in the houses behind us.
Absolutely. But there is another source of these surges, so let's go and have a look at that now.
So you brought me to another beautiful location, Joe, but why are we here?
We're here looking at another potential source of surges. If you look at the properties behind us, you can see one on the end. We've got lovely domestic cottages on the end there, followed by a commercial building, and then over here, we've got a big industrial building. Now, inside here, they might have big rotating machinery, perhaps lathes, drills, mills, that kind of thing. And those items, as they're switching on and off, can actually cause surges into the electrical system, supplying that domestic property on the end there.
So electronic devices up and down the country aren't failing in domestic dwellings all the time, Joe. So how do I know I'm at risk of a surge?
Well, it depends on a number of things. If we work backwards through the things we've already discussed, if you look around your area and if your building is close to a property that is maybe an industrial manufacturing plant or something like that, it could be that the machines turning on and off inside there can start to have an impact on your installation in terms of providing those surges that we want to avoid.
And what about the location in relationship to the UK? Am I more likely to have a lightning strike in one area?
Yep, bearing in mind, of course, when we talk about lightning strikes, we don't mean lightning hitting your property. We're talking about lightning hitting the supply that surrounds your property and feeds your property. And so the further south in the country you get, generally speaking, you're at increased risk from a lightning strike. However, we can also say that if you live in a rural area, you're also more at risk from a lightning strike.
Okay, and talking of lightning strikes, what if I'm near a very large high-rise building?
Yeah, that's a bit of a different one, because under those circumstances, if you're in or near a very tall building that has a lightning protection system inside it, then chances are that if lightning strikes that building, it's going to cause a surge inside your property, even though you haven't been struck by lightning in your property.
Shall we have a look at a surge protection device next? So popped inside, it's time to see the device that will protect our sensitive electronic equipment within our domestic dwelling. We've got to show us, Joe.
So here we're looking at the surge protection device, also referred to as an SPD.
And where would we get the electrician to fit it for us?
The electrician will fit it where it needs to activate to keep your property safe. So they might decide to fit it inside the consumer unit. So if we just lift that lid up.
Okay, yep. And it's just positioned there next to the main switch, yes?
Absolutely.
Okay, where else could they fit it?
The electrician may also decide to fit this in a separate unit, perhaps near your electricity meter.
Okay, give us a brief overview of how they work.
They work a little bit like a pressure relief valve does for a water system. So if you've got a pipe filled with water and the pressure inside there gets too high, If a pressure relief valve has been fitted, it will activate and the water will come out of the system safely. And this works in a similar way, but for electricity. So if the voltage or electrical pressure inside your system gets too high, then this automatically operates. You don't need to do anything to make it do that. It just does it by itself. And it simply diverts the electricity to a safe place, meaning that it can't get to those delicate electronic components causing damage.
What's it going to cost me?
Don't think about it in terms of cost. Think about it in terms of value. If you look around your property right now and think about the types of devices that you've got there, maybe just your telly. I mean, if we go online, we're struggling to find a telly cheaper than 100 quid. If a surge event happens and that telly gets destroyed, that's another 100 quid at least that you've got to shell out. This is going to cost you less than £100, which means that if a surge event does occur, this will offer protection, meaning that you've saved yourself the £100 cost of replacing that very, very cheap telly. Not to mention all of the other devices that you might have connected, your washing machine, your dishwasher, your tumble dryer, DVD player, all those other things.
It reminds me of the story. When's the most common time to fit yourself a burglar alarm?
Yeah, most people get an intruder alarm fitted just after they've been burgled, don't they? So what we're thinking about here is showing a little bit of foresight. Wouldn't it be great to fit an intruder alarm before the burglar comes along? Wouldn't it be great to show some foresight and get a surge protection device fitted before the surge event happens and destroys your electronic components?
It sure would. So if the viewers are interested in getting surge protection fitted, Joe, what's the next steps?
The best thing you can do is contact your local electrician and ask them to come round, do a survey and have a look to see where the surge protection would be best fitted.
If you enjoyed this video, there may be other videos in this series that interest you. We've done a video on does my property need a rewire? I've also done one where a consumer unit's been changed for the latest one, which includes surge protection. So please make sure you check out those videos. I think we're just left with one phrase to go, are we, Joe?
Thank you very much for watching. For further information, please head to electrium.co.uk.